Hello everybody, my dear children, how are you all? I know and I hope that you are all so safe and enjoying your holidays. Am I right? Okay, now a small extra enjoyment for you. It is nothing but our EVS class. Shall we start our class with small prayer? Okay, tell along with me. Thank you, God, for giving us a wonderful day here. Kindly bless us and guide us for our studies. Okay. Shall we start our lesson? First of all, you have to know what is environmental studies. In this, what we are going to study and learn. So, I'm going to explain first what is environmental studies. It is nothing but a study about the human interaction with the environment. Here, environment in the sense, nothing but our surrounding. And the human interaction as a human, what we are doing in our surrounding. That's it. For example, suppose if you are moving to any water area, there what kind of activities you can do. And suppose if you are in school, what are all the things around you? Like that, many things. What are all the things related with our environment is known as our environmental studies. Okay, in this environmental studies class, our first chapter is Supersenses. By the name itself, you can get some ideas, right? Everything, human being, animal, or any bird can have its own speciality. Likewise, can you say about your speciality? First, take one rough note or one paper. In that, just write about your speciality in a single line. For example, I can smell a flower's smell wherever it is. Like that, you can write your special character. Whether it's no need to be a smell or a taste or a hearing sense. Whatever it may be, just write your special thing. And shall we move to our lesson? In this lesson, we are going to study about animals and their super senses. Our first concept is adaptation. And look at the slide. Can you able to see the cheetah? Can you say what is its adaptation? That means where it can survive? In the jungle, right? In the forest. Like that, adaptation means it is a characteristic that an organism in the sense we can say any animal or plant, has evolved that helps it to survive in its environment. Environment in the sense for the plants and the animals definitely be very different. By means, some animals can able to live in deserts and some animals might not. Like that, some plants can live in desert area but others might not. Can you think how is this possible? Because of this adaptation. I think now you can get some idea about adaptations. Okay, there are two main types of adaptations, and they are, the first one is structural adaptation and the second one is behavioral adaptation. Okay, first let me explain about the structural adaptation. Can you able to see the duck? What is its sound? quack, 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 right? Okay. Medicine, it is depends upon its body parts. Body parts of that an organism has that help it to survive. Can we take this duck as example for this? Did you notice duck's feet anywhere? If it is possible, means kindly note it hereafter. The webbed feet of a duck help it to run and walk faster in the water. Like a duck, plants also have some structural adaptation. And one more example also we can say, that is an insulating fur of the Siberian husky. It is nothing but a type of dog. Okay. And our next concept is behavioral adaptation. Behavioral adaptation in the sense, because of its behavior, any animal can survive in this environment. For example, a millipede. Do you know millipede? Yes, during the rainy season it arounds in the tree side, right? Yes, a creature that curls up when it is touched. Likewise, oxen, you know all, right? Oxen form a circle around their young ones when the predators are near. Likewise, many animals and many plants have its behavioral adaptations. Okay, now answer for my question. How is food found? I'm not asking for animal. How you guys are getting food? From your parents, right? Then how your parents are getting these foods? By earning some money. With the help of that money, they can buy something and they will prepare the food and give it to you. Am I right? Okay. Like the same way are all animals are getting the food? No. Okay. All animals have some kind of adaptation to help them get the food they need to survive. Let me see about some examples for this chapter. And the first example is cheetah. Do you know how can it get its food? And do you know what is the speciality or the super sense of cheetah? It is nothing but it can run faster. It is able to run very fast and thus is able to catch its prey. What do you mean by prey? It is nothing. We used to call it our eatable things as food, right? Like that, animals' eatable things are prey. So, cheetah can able to run fast, more faster, so that it can able to catch its prey. And what is echidna? Can you able to see in the slide, the picture? It is only echidna. It has a long and thin nose which makes it easy for them to burrow for ants. We can say this thing as an anteater also. Okay. And the next one, spider. You can see at your home. Am I right? Spider. So they have a stick glands which enables them to spin sticky webs. In that only they can move from one place to another. And the next one is pelican. It is a large spoon shaped beak which allows them to scoop food. It is also one example. And the final example is woodpecker. They have strong, sharp beaks to tear bark of trees. So, these are all the examples for some kind of adaptations to help them to get some food. Because of that only, they need to survive in this environment. And look at the picture. What is this? Now can you all know what are these pictures? Why I have shown this thing means many animals and plants have special features in the sense they can easily escape from their preys. For example, some animals are covered with hard scales and plates. And some other animals have spine or spikes on their bodies. And some of the animals stay together to protect themselves. These are all the ways used by that animals to escape from their preys. Okay, look at that. First one is porcupine fish. Look at that body, spines on the body. Am I right? Because of these spines, definitely no other animal can touch this. And the second one is zebras. Stay in group, right? Can you identify where the zebra is? Look at this. Yes, at in the center. By staying in a group, zebras can escape from the predators. And the final one is anteater. The body is covered with spine. Because of this only, it can escape from their preys. Okay children, our next concept is camouflage. What do you mean by camouflage? It is nothing but some animals can easily blend so well with their surroundings that cannot be seen easily or that cannot be recognized easily. This adaptation concept is known it as camouflage. Body covering of a single color not easily seen when surrounding are of that color. For example, we can say snow owl, Arctic fox. An easy example is, look at that, in that picture, one insect is there. Can you able to spot an insect? Yes, it is none other than a stick insect. Most of us were not able to see it as it is well camouflaged. This thing, that stick insect is there now, that is mingled with that plant. This concept, this adaptation is known as camouflage. Okay, and next thing is staying cool and keeping warm. What is this? Staying cool in the sense, in the desert area, camel used to live, right? That animal is living in the hot places, right? Then how it is adapting that hot with the help of that body? How in the sense, animals that live in hot place have certain ways to adapt to their surroundings. Some animals can dig holes and go inside and stay out of the sun. Others are able to drink large amounts of water at one time, and that water can be maintained in their body throughout the day. Most desert plants have shallow roots to absorb water rapidly. And keeping warm in the sense, one side the desert is too hot, animal can have to survive in that area, like camel. In some other side, the place is very cool. It is too cool. In that area also, animals have to live. How in the sense, in that area, cool places also, some animals have some certain ways to adapt to their surroundings. Because they will be having a layer of insulating fat and also a layer of thick fur covered by a layer of waterproof fur to keep themselves warm. Birds also have some adapted to living in cold environment. Why means they are having feathers? No. So that feathers used to help them to keep warm. If it gets too cold, they fly to warmer environments. Now this behavior adaptation is known it as migration. Migration, what do you mean by migration? Migration means birds usually fly from one place to another place. No. So birds are moving from one place to another place. This adaptation characteristic is known as migration. Look at this side camel and that side. What is that? That is nothing but Siberian cat. And this side, the camel can able to survive in the hottest area of like a desert. Likewise, in the right side, look at the Siberian cat. Look at the fur. The body is covered with full of fur, no? Because of that, it can also survive in the too cold areas. And the next concept is moving on land. Animals that move on land may have legs with powerful muscles, right? Because of that powerful muscles only, it can overcome the forces of gravity and the friction. Friction means when one thing is touches the another thing, what will happen? That is only known as friction. These forces oppose movement on land. Animals that move on land may also have modified feet. For example, what we can say, the feet of the horse and the kangaroo are adapted to help these animals to move on the land, isn't it? And some animals with legs may move about by hopping, walking and running. This you can accept, I know. And animals with no legs, what we can say as example? Yes, example is snakes. So the snakes are able to crawl or slither on the land. So every animal, whether it is moving by hopping, walking or running or crawling, whatever it may be, they have some adaptations to protect the lower part of their bodies, which experience friction as they drag along the ground. Definitely, right? When you walk without your chappal, what will happen to your foot? Is that can adaptable by you? In some cases it can be adaptable, but all the time in the sense it will never suitable for a human being. But for the animals, by naturally they are having some special, some unique things in their feet. And the next thing is moving in water. Anything that moves in water experience a force called water resistance. So water resistance in the sense, any animal or anything that moves in the water experience force called as water resistance. Definitely, it acts against the direction of movement. Will you all agree with me? It acts against the direction of movement only, right? Just like that, we have seen that moving on land, right? Just like that. And what is the another name for water animals? Anybody knows? Yes, that is aquatic animals. Aquatic animals have streamlined body shape to reduce the effects of water resistance. Every animal can have the same criteria in their body? No. Land animals can survive in the land only. Likewise, the water animal can have some special things, some special criteria in their body. Why means they have to survive in the different area, no? Like water. So aquatic animals may also have modified limbs like flippers and webbed feet. Okay, already we have seen, no, that webbed feet. What is that? Who is having that webbed feet? Yes, duck. Because of this webbed feet only, the duck can easily able to move in the water, right? And what is this? Bird, crow, right? So next, our next topic is adaptations on flight. Flight in the sense, don't think any airways, airlines. Here they are telling the birds is a flight. Flight means they can move through air only, no, from one place to another. So they are moving in the air. In that sense, they are just mentioning adaptations on flight. Have well-developed wings. Definitely, no, the first criteria is have well-developed wings. Definitely. Because of that wings only, one bird can move from one place to another place. And the second point is have powerful flight muscles for flapping their wings. Definitely, with the wings only, they can't able to move from one place to another place. They should have powerful flight muscles, which one will helps to fly from one place to another place. And the next thing is are covered with feathers for warmth, allowing flight muscle to work properly. These feathers only allowing that flight muscles, we have studied now in the second point, a powerful flight muscles to work properly. And the feathers of birds are so light and strong, so ideal for wings. Do you know one thing? That birds are having hollow and strong bones. Do you know that that hollow bones that are filled with air? Why means to reduce the body weight. And the final point is streamlined body so can overcome air resistance. Okay, and the next thing is predatory birds such as eagles, falcons and hawks also have excellent eyesight. So which are the birds having their excellent eyesight? Such as eagles, falcons and hawks, right? They can spot their prey from a very long distance away and then rapidly swoop down to capture it. So they are very faster and they are very sharp in their eyesight too, right? Because of these special characteristics only, they can able to spot out their prey from a very long distance. And so tell along with me the examples for that birds are crow, sparrow, eagle, seagull, hawks, falcon, owl and duck. Okay. And breathing in the water. how some aquatic animals are breathing in water? Let me explain. Some aquatic animals are adapted to be able to take in dissolved oxygen from water. And shall I ask one question to you? What is the symbol of water? H2O, right? So hydrogen plus oxygen. So some aquatic animals can be able to take in the dissolved oxygen from the water. And some aquatic animal may live in water but come up to the surface to take air. So they can't able to take the air inside the water. So they will come up to the surface and to take the water. And some other aquatic animals can live in water and on land. They are adapted to take in dissolved oxygen when in water and breathe air when on land. Okay, so because we already know that some water animals, some animals can able to live in both water and the land. So in that cases, that animal can take their dissolved oxygen when they were in water and breathe air when they were in land. Okay. What are all the things we can say as example means? Fishes, shrimp, frog tadpole, toad tadpole, dragonfly nymph, and these are all gills. And leech, worms, they will be having soft thin skin that can take in dissolved oxygen. And mosquito larva, water scorpion, water stick insect, they are having air tube or breathing tube that sticks out above the water surface to take in air. So all the water animals will not get their air inside the water only. So some animals, some water animals or aquatic animals, they can come upon to the land for getting the air. And the next concept is adapting to low light. Adapting to low light in the sense, some nocturnal animals that can be asleep during the daytime and awake in the whole night. How it is possible during the night? How can it see? How in the sense they have special adaptations which enables them to see even though in at the night. The retina in these nocturnal creatures are large to collect more light. How in the sense nocturnal animals have huge eyes. The eyes filled nearly half of this animal's skull. My God. So the size of eyes is huge, right? And the bad thing about this is that they are not able to move their eyes freely. In this sense, one question has to arrive to you, right? What is that question? Then other birds can rotate their eyes? Okay, let me see. The bad thing about this is that they are not able to move their eyes freely. To overcome this limited movement, most nocturnal animals' head can be rotated nearly 270 degrees. So it can easily see. Look at the slide. This is one example for that nocturnal animals. Next thing is plants. Some plants may be live in a low light environments. For instance, in a rainforest, most of the light is absorbed by the top canopy layers. Definitely, right? In the forest, that means a thick forest covered with thick trees, right? So most of the sunlight is absorbed by the top of the layer. So the plants on the rainforest floor have huge leaves which enables them to absorb more sunlight at one time. So what are all the things can be done with these plants means in the rainforest flow have huge leaves which enables them to absorb more sunlight at one time itself. So most of them are able to grow on stems of other tall plants so as to reach higher areas in the rainforest where more light is available. Look at this. And now we are going to see some super senses. Our title is there, no? Some super senses of some animals. The first thing is pig. I think everybody knows this thing well. So pig's most important sense is the taste. They have got over 15,000 taste buds. And so because of this only, its important sense is the taste. And the next one is eagle. Look at this picture. What is this? Eagle. So eagle most important sense is the eyesight. Already we have seen, right? In one slide we had seen. Am I right or not, children? Because of this eyesight only, that eagle can see its prey from many distance, many kilometer distance apart, right? So they can see a small mouse in the grass from high up in the sky. So what is the eagle's most important sense? Yes, eyesight. And the next thing, leopard. Leopard's most important sense is the touch. They have got sensitive whiskers. They can touch things in the dark and feel where they are going. Wow, what a sense. So what is the important sense of a leopard? Yes, touch. And the next one is owls. Owls most important sense is the smell. They have got a very sensitive nose and can smell friends, enemies and food. Obviously, owls definitely can have the important sense as smell. And the next thing is dolphins. Dolphins have got very sensitive ears. So the super sense of dolphin is hearing. Hearing is the most important sense of dolphin. They can hear very well and communicate with other dolphins. Wow, what a super sense of dolphin, right? Okay. This is a small evaluation for you, dear. And before that, I want to share one thing. What are all the things we have crossed in this PowerPoint presentation? The first thing is adaptation, right? What do you mean by adaptation? Means it is a characteristic that an organism in the sense we can say any plant or animal has evolved that helps it to survive in its environment. Am I right? And so in that adaptation we have seen two types of adaptations, right? The first thing is structural adaptation and the second thing is behavioral adaptation. Am I right? And the next thing is how the animals are getting their food. Like human, we are also eating, right? Like that, animals also eating food. How they are getting food, that we have studied. And the next thing is what we had seen, how the animals are escape from its surrounding, right? they can easily escape, right? That thing we have studied. And the next thing is camouflage. Camouflage means, do you all remember the adaptation which one animal can blend with their surrounding? So because of this adaptation only, we cannot recognize any animal or easily or seen easily, right? And staying cool and keeping warm. Staying cool in the sense, in the hottest area like deserts, how camel can survive in its life. And likewise, how in the cold area, how the animals are keeping warm. So these things we have studied. And the next concept is moving on land. So if we want to move on land, means we are having leg and some features, right? Likewise, animals also have some special features to walk on land. Not only by walk, but also hop, run, crawl, right? So one animal can move by these variety of ways. And the next thing is moving in water. For example, the webbed feet of duck, we can say, no, how it is moving against of the force, right? And the next thing is moving on flight. Flight in the sense air. So a bird is the example for this, right? From this only we had seen one new concept, that migration, right? Migration in the sense birds are moving from one place to another place is known as migration. And the next thing is breathing in water, right? How an animal can able to breathe in water. Some can breathe the dissolved oxygen, and some animal can come upon to the land for breathing the air. And the next thing is adapting to low light, right? Animals as well as plants are all adapting to low light, because some nocturnal animals we have seen, they can sleep during the daytime and awake during the night time, right? Likewise, plants also adapting to low light. How in the sense, in the forest area, the too thick tree covered in that forest means the top area only can get the sunlight easily. So other parts of the bird plant, how it will be used means, at a time they can get the sunlight, and they will spread through of its parts. And the last thing what we have studied, some animals and super sense. What is the pig's super sense? Yes, a taste. And the eagles, right, eyesight. And leopards, very good touch. And wolves, nothing but smell, right? And then finally dolphin. What is the super sense of dolphin? Yes, a hearing sense. I think now you have get some idea about the super senses of animals, right, my dear children? Here a small evaluation for you. In your note, just write these things and match the animal with their super sense. Tiger means, for example, one I will say, tiger in the sense, what is the super sense of tiger? Vision, right? What is the super sense of tiger? Vision. Okay, shall I say for all those things? Okay, then what is the super sense of pig? Guess. Yes, taste. And the super sense of wolf? Smell. And the super sense of dolphin? Exactly, hearing. And eagle? Yes, a sight. Okay. Okay, name the following animals. This is your homework, dear. So do it well. Write the name the following animals as a title and write all the five. And in the dash, write your answer. And for this presentation, I'm going to give some homework. What is that? The first thing is, write the new words from this presentation. What are all the new words you learnt from this presentation? You have to write separately. And the second question is, name any five birds, an animal's name and its super senses. Very easy, right? And one more thing, the final one is your project. Prepare one paper animal face mask. Try to do during this quarantine period. I think you all get some knowledge and idea about the super senses of animals. Am I right, my dear children? Okay, be safe and thank you.